So guys, in this video we will be looking at the arithmetic operations, mainly addition and subtraction in this video. In the next video we will be taking a look at the multiplication and division. So let's get started. So this addition operation is general, everyone knows about it. It's a general day-to-day life addition operation, just adding two numbers, but I will be showing in the binary format. Let's say example 11 plus 9 is equals to 20. We all know that. Now let's forget that 20 is the result and we will derive this 20. Now convert this 11 into binary format. You can do the division method by 2 and so on, and you reverse the remainders. So after that you get like this 01011, or another method is you simply write the 2 powers and you can just add those bits, right? Means 11, 8 plus 2 plus 1, that's 11. So you can put the 1 in these bits and remaining as 0. So 11 in binary format is 01011. So this is the binary format of 11. In the same way, we can find the binary format for 9, which is 0, 1 and 1. You need to set the bits for 8 and 1 and remaining are 0. So on addition you will get 1 into 8 plus 1 into 1, which is 9 in decimal format. So we have converted these two numbers into binary formats, and now let's add these two binary numbers. So here 1 plus 1. So normal 1 plus 1 is 2, but in binary format we must convert that into the binary format, right? 2 in the binary format is 10. So you put the 0 and the 1 will be the carry to this part, and here 11, again it results in the 10, which is 2, and put the 0 in here, and then 1 is the carry. So 100 on addition you will get 1, and in the same way 1 plus 1, which is 10, which means 2 in decimal, 10 in binary. So you put the 0 in here and 1 in here, and 100 on addition you get 1. So this is the our required binary result of addition of these two numbers. Now let's convert that into decimal. So 16 bit is on and 4 bit is on. So 1 into 16 plus 1 into 4, which is 20. So this is how you do the binary addition. Now we will do the subtraction. There is no separate concept like subtraction. What you going to do is you take one positive number and you take another negative number, and you gonna add those two numbers to get the result. That is subtraction. So before going to subtraction, I want to tell you one thing called sign magnitude. Let's take this example 9. If you want to convert that 9 into minus 9, what you going to do is you need to put the MSB bit into 1. So this is the MSB bit, that is leftmost significant bit. And if you put it to 1, so that will be the 9. And this bit corresponding value will be the negative. So if I put 1 here, you will get the minus 16. Minus 1 into 16 plus 1 into 8 plus 1 into 1. It means minus 6, minus 16 plus 8 plus 1, which is minus 16 plus 9. So which is, okay, sorry. I think this maybe the MSB bit. Okay, if you want to turn into the MSB bit, then you need to put the MSB bit as 1 to get the negative number. But that sign magnitude form is very inefficient in the subtraction operations because you get the wrong results. That's why there is another form called 2's complement form. So in this 2's complement form, we will do the subtraction operations. So how to get the 2's complement form means we need to find the 1 complement form, and how to get the 1 complement form means we need to flip the all the bits from 0's to 1's and 1's to 0's. So if the bit is 0, you need to flip it to 1. If the bit is 1, you need to flip it to 0. And after getting the 1's complement, we need to add plus 1 to this 1's complement to get the 2's complement. So let's see with an example. So this is the 9 in the decimal format, and this is the binary equivalent 8 plus 1 9, so 01001. So to get the 1's complement, you change all 0's to 1's and all 1's to 0's. So this is 0 and I'm changing to 1 1 0 0 to 1 0 to 1 1 to 0. So we got our 1's complement form. Now we going to add plus 1, add 1 to the this 1's complement form to get the 2's complement form. So let's add plus 1. So it is, this is simple addition, 1 plus 0 1. So the final minus 9 will be 1 0 1 1 1. In the previous video, if we put the MSB bit as 1, we get the wrong answer because that is not correct method for subtraction or addition. That's why now we check this. This is the MSB bit and minus 1, this one, this one is the minus 1, minus 1 into 16, minus 16 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. So minus 16 plus 7, which is minus 9. So this 2's complement form is correct for subtraction operations. Now let's see what is the equivalent of 11 plus 9, 11 plus minus 9. All right, we already knew that 11's binary equivalent is 01011, and minus 9 we have got from the previous slide, 10111, which is a 2's complement. Now we just simply add this. So 1 plus 1, which is 10, which means 2 in by decimal. So you put the 0 here and the left carry here. 1 will be placed here, and this addition 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is 3 in the binary format, which is 1 1, right? You put the 1 here and another 1 here on the carry. So on putting the 1, you get 1 plus 0 plus 1, which is 2, which means 10 in binary. You put the right value 0 here and the 1 in the carry. So 1 plus 1 plus 0, which gives 2, which gives again 2, and which again 0 1, and again 1 plus 0 plus 1 0 1. So we have got the extra carry and we need to ignore that because we are doing only the particular 5 bits and we don't need to include the 32 part here. We just ignore that carry. So our resultant will be the our answer. So 11 minus 9 is 2. Let's check that in binary equivalent. So only 2 bit is on. So that's why 1 into 2 plus everything 0, which is 2. So this is how you perform subtraction operation. Subtraction is nothing but adding the one positive number and a negative number, and that's it. Now we will see how to perform these operations using the assembly language. So there is an add instruction which we have seen in the basic instructions video. Now we will see that again. So add EAX comma 2. So what this means is take the contents of EAX and take 2 value, add them both and put that in EAX register because this is the destination register. So its equivalent is EAX is equals to EAX plus 2. In the same way, we can add particular 16 bits of the EAX register. I already mentioned that we can access the lower 16 bits using the AX and also lower 8 bits using the AL. In the same way, previous example, AX becomes incremented by 2. That means added by 2. And in the same way, addition operation, subtraction operation can also be performed. And there are two more operations called increment and decrement operations. And this increment EAX increases the value by 1. So that's the default value. It's gonna increase the register. So increment EAX means EAX is equals to EAX plus 1, and decrement ECX means ECX is equal to ECX minus 1. So these two are the basic operations of addition and subtraction, and also increment and decrement. And I want to say is if we add full 32 bits and 32 bits, and then sometimes overflow may occur, and that overflow will be stored in the EDX register, and also overflow flag will be set. And also if we subtract two numbers, two equivalent numbers, say subtract 5, 5, then the resultant operation is 0, then the extended flags 0 flag is set. Okay, we will see this in the Ubuntu VM. Now let's go on to Ubuntu VM and let's write some examples. So guys, now I'm going to create a say add sub dot nasm. Now I am going to write the global tick, global start. Now I am not going to write the data section because we will directly put the values in the instructions. So I am directly writing the text section. Okay, now let's clear the EAX register so that we can make sure that 0 is in the EAX register. Now we can add the lower 8 bits of EAX register only. So we can say AL comma 12. So hexadecimal 12 represents 8 bits and AL also represent 8 bits. So addition is performed. Now we will add AH accumulator higher register to 34. Okay, let's say this one is 34, this one is 12. So the lower bits gonna be placed by added by 34 and the higher bits are added by 12. Since we have the full 0 bits, simply these values will be placed here. Now up to now AX register holds the 1, 2, 3, 4 because these are the higher bits and these are the lower bits. Now let's add some value to the AX register. Okay, up to now we have got the 1, 2, 3, 4 in hexadecimal for AX and we are adding 2. So the result would be 1, 2, 3, 6. Now let's move that value into EBX. Or you can just simply move to the BX. Now what I am going to do is I am going to subtract this AX and BX. Since AX and BX contains the same values, the resultant operation would be 0 and then the 0 flag will be set. Now let's also write some code for increment and decrement. So remember guys, this, okay, I'll be showing another one example. Move AL comma 0. So like this, we can only move particular value into the particular lower 8 bits. This is very important when we are talking about shell coding, because if we move EAX comma 0, we get the null bytes when we convert it to the shell code. That's why we add particularly 8 bits so that we don't get extra null bytes. Okay, I will cover the topic in detail in the shell coding section. Now let's save this file. Now let's compile using NASM. Now let's link the object file using LD. Okay, even if you run the program, it will exit normally because we did not print anything. That's why I'm going to open the binary directly in the GDB. Now let's say info functions. We have the start function, let's put the breakpoint at that. Now let's run our program. Now as you can see, the first instruction is going to be move AX comma 0. Now let's execute that. So AX is 0. Now next instruction is move AL comma 0. Let's also execute that. Okay, EAX is also 0. Now we are moving the 0x34 into lower 8 bits of EAX register. As you can see, EAX contains 0x34. Now the interesting part is we are moving the we are adding the 12 into the with the contents of the AH register, which is 0, and 0 plus 0x12, which gives 0x12. Now the result would be EAX contains 1234. As you can see, the EAX contains 1234. Now we are adding AX and 02. So AX contains 1234, and if we add 0x2, it becomes 0x1236, and that also will be stored in the EAX. So as you can see, EAX contains 1236. Now we are going to move the 1236 value into the BX. Let's do that. I am just hitting enter to that will execute my previous command, which is the next instruction. Okay, now EBX EAX contains the same values. Now if we subtract those two values, this zero flag will become red color and in capital letters, because the zero flag is set. As you can see, the zero flag is set, and also EAX contains zero because we are storing the result in the AX register, which is EAX. And now I am going to move the zero into the ECX value, ECX register, and ECX contains 0. Now let's increment the ECX register. Now ECX contains 1. So increment operator just increments, adds the value 1. That's it. And now we are going to decrement the ECX register. 1 minus 1, it's 0. So these increment and decrement operations are used in the loop instructions, loop operations. You will see that in the future videos. So that's all about this addition and subtraction. I hope you have understood.